Hi friends, this is Vetrivel. This tutorial I will teach how to create a LMS. LMS means library management system. So here I will let you show the flow diagram for how to make a project. In that project what and all options will be provided and all I will teach. So here this is my rough program. So see, LMS, library management system, having a login. First I came open that my project, it will come as a login window here. See, login window. In login window I have two options. One is, in case you forget the password, that time you have to go to navigate to change a password window, and you are successfully login, you have to navigate into home screen. So in that home screen I have three options. One is master, another one is report, another one is inventory. See, master, we will discuss about master first. Master, what is this master? Master means is a fixed one means it already we have to implement some details, example product names and users, that and all is comes under master category. So here in master I have five options. One is profile, section, rack, member, plan. So while creating profile I have to add role here, so it will navigate, it will interlink with this profile, because the profile means we are creating the login users. That time we have to assign the roles, admin, that user is a admin, that user is a client, like that we have to demo user, guest users, so many options. We will maintain this role sections. In section means every library have a sections, English, English, Max, Mathematics, Science, like that so many section will be, that section details we will maintain here. Rack, so in that section how many rack will be there, that rack details we will maintain here. And member, for library having the membership, that time the member details will be maintained here. And plan, for member we need to maintain the plan, so plan basis they will pay the money and all. So this criteria is comes under master. Now we'll discuss about report. Reports must, in every project report is very very needed. See, reports having four sections. One is member, stock, book in and out, and collections. So member having member report, stock means how many book is there, that stock report will become here. And book in and out, member will taking the books in and out, that means he taking the book in outside and giving the 2 or 3 days, depends upon the library rules, that time the maintaining how many book in outside is gone and how many book in inside is there, that details we are maintaining here. And collection means in case member delay they are giving the book while in and out, they are giving delay, that time he have to pay the fine, that details we will maintaining here. Collections as well as member plan details is there, say a member choose any plan, that time they pay the money, that money also comes in collection. So in that collection also maintaining here, collection report. Okay, and inventory. So this is the backbone of the library, because based on inventory only we can maintaining the books lot more, and we can maintaining the customers. So here while purchasing, because in library it doesn't sell the books, they will use for purchase only, so that's why I am not included here sales. Inventory, normally inventory means purchase and sales will be there, here I will use only purchase. Okay, so in that purchase and book register in and out, so in inventory section only we are maintaining the book register here, in and out. Okay, that in and out report will be comes here, in and book reports section, in and out, that is the our flow chart of the our program. Okay, now Now, other thing. So, now I will discuss about data flow. See, this is our data structure. So, based on this structure only, we will create the database in SQL Server or anything. Which database you are using, in the database you have to create this kind of structures here. So, we will discuss about this data structures. See, master having profile master, role master, member master, plan master, and book master, section master, rack master, and rack section master. Okay, profile master, we are maintaining the profile details like many users or admin or anybody is there, that details we are maintaining here. Okay, profile master. In role master, we are maintaining the role. So that means this profile master and role master is interlink. That means this is a relational database management. So here member master, they are maintaining the member details here, and plan master, we are maintaining the plan details here. And we will discuss about these columns we are using and all. We will discuss later. And bookmaster, they are maintaining the book details, book about the books we are maintaining. And section master and rack master and rack map master. So section master, how many section will be there? Rack master, how many rack will be there? Those two are linked into section rack map. That table is interlinked with these two tables, joined with two tables, and stored into this table. That is, and inventory, purchase main and purchase sub. So purchase main, we are maintaining the purchase main details, and purchase sub, here we are maintaining the related to purchase and purchase sub. Okay, stock master, here we are maintaining the book stocks here. And member transaction, here we are maintaining our members payments, like plan payments, fine payments, what and all we are paying, that and all we are maintaining here. Okay, and book register, here maintaining the book details, like book main and book sub main, we are maintaining the in and out details we are maintaining here. Okay, so we will discuss about our UI diagram. UI, how the UI will be there and all, we have to maintain right now. That and all also I will teach here. Okay, now I go to login page here. See, this is the login page. Username and password and change password will be there. See, profile master. So in profile master only we are accessing for login. Also we didn't create the separate login table for that. See, here profile password is there and profile user ID is there. So user ID comes here and profile password will comes here. Okay, once you change the password also, we navigate into change window. So change password, say here, once change the password, we need to provide the existing username and existing old password and current password. New password, they are giving a new password, then change means it will change into profile master. This is a simple concept. And in home page, I have master and inventory section. We already discussed about in LMS, we have discussed master and reports and inventory, that and all it comes into this home page sections. Okay, master and inventory, like that menu will be come here. Okay, now we go to role. So role table, based on this role master, I will create the role table here. So role ID and role, and role status, active or inactive. So sometimes we need to active that role and sometimes we need to hide that role. That time we will use this. So once new and update, delete, save option will be there. Once it save, that record will be stored into our grid view. So how many record will be there, that count also we will show here. Okay, now go to section. In that section, based on section master, I will create section. So we already seen role master how to create. Same wise here it will create the sections. And section rack. Section rack, we will maintaining the section master, rack master, and section rack master. These three table only we are maintaining, not this table. So no need this table. Okay, three table only we are maintaining. So rack ID. So section rack ID. So section rack ID is SRID. Nothing but SRID. And rack name, it will come into this rack name. It and section name, it will come section name here, and print order, it will come print order here in status. We are in this table, we are only storing these values, but by while saving this records, we have to consider these two tables. So record will be fetching from these two tables. So based on section ID, we will get the section name. Based on rack ID, we will get the rack name, and we will set the print order, and we will show save into this section rack master. That's it. Okay, and we will see plan. So this is the plan master. In plan ID, plan name, plan DOC. DOC means date of creation, and book limit. Book limit means so per plan we will give the limitation for taking book. So per month they will give 10 books we can take the home, and we need to return. So every book we need to hold, how many days they can hold. So 3 days they can hold, or 4 days they can hold, or 1 month they can hold. So holding will be here. Validity. So holding means, limitation is 10. At a time, how many book they can hold. So at a time they will take 3 book also. That 3 book or 4 book, that holding we are maintaining here. And validity, every book how many days the validity. So 3 days validity or 1 month validity. See, though within 1 month they need to return the books. And plan amount. So for this plan amount, how much will be there, and plan discount, any discount will be there, they are maintaining, and plan status. So that and all we created here. So and new, update, delete, save, and row record we are maintaining for this plan master. Okay, and profile master, we will discuss about profile master. Okay, profile master having profile ID, profile user ID and name and email and mobile and password and address and role and sections. Okay, here user ID, name, everything we are created, but this role, it comes from the data is role master is there, na? Where is role master? Control C. Okay, where is section profile. Okay, see this role master, role ID, this role name, it will interlink with this role. See this role is there, na? So this role interlinked, it automatically interlink. Okay, see this profile master and role master, it interlinked with here. So profile ID, profile name, everything is here, and this two details will be two table with interlinked here. Okay, and book in and out, book register main and book register sub, two table will be there. Book register details means book ID and register date and member ID and status we are maintaining for book register main. Book register main means this register ID will be stored here, and date will be stored, register date will be stored here, and member ID and register status we are maintaining this table. And book register sub, here we are maintaining the sub details. See one register ID, they will take too many books, two book or three book, that details we are maintaining and stored here. So here register ID, register date, and so sub table should be need. So how many transaction they made, that time we will take refer this table. How many books they are taken totally, in that time they will refer this table. So this is the table normalization. I will teach how to use that in further video sections. Okay, and this is book out register. While returning that book, we have to enter the register ID, or based on member ID, we have to find out the member ID and how many books they are written and all. We have to find out this. Okay. And purchase. Purchase, we are using the purchase main and purchase sub. Here purchase ID, purchase day, from date, amount, everything is there. Like that, how the book out register is there. No? Like that, here purchase main, we are maintaining purchase ID and purchase days, purchase from vendor name, we are maintaining here, and status here. Book ID and book name, quantity, rate, amount, add means it will add all the records into this grid view. Finally, we have to save that record stored into these two tables. So this purchase ID and purchase date, it will store in one time in this purchase main, and this how many rows record will be there, that and all stored into multiple times. Multiple time means how many rows is there, that much time it will store into this purchase sub. So for that only we are using this transaction. And member transaction. Member transaction means they are paying the plan fees, or here we will choose plan fees or fine or anything we need to pay here. That transaction will be maintained. And member, so this is member, sorry, book creation, book ID, book name, author, and the edition, how many pages, about the books, they are maintaining we are maintaining these details and all. After anything I missed, that much only. Okay, now we gonna to create the project in this kind of, based on this layout and data flow and workflow.
Now we will, based on this data structure, we will create the database,
and we have to create the tables. So for that I have SQL Server, SQL Server Management Studio. We need to install SQL Server Management Studio. So we need to run the SQL Server Management. So SSMS, just enter SSMS. That means SQL Server Management Studio, that is SSMS. Control R, press Control R. You have to type SSMS. You already installed SQL Server Management Studio. It will run here. Just I will connect my database, my server, not the database. In the server I will create the so many DBs. Here already I created the LMS DB. So how to create the DB first? So right click, new DB, new database. In that new database I will type any name, our database name, example LMS. I will create the LMS and click OK. So like that database will create here. So for the time being I already created the DB, that is LMS DB. So for that I will delete this DB, no need this DB. So I will use this LMS DB only. In that LMS DB table section we will create the tables. So already I created based on this structure. See, plan, profile master, role master, member master, like that we will create profile master, role master, and member master. So many tables I created here. So just you need to create the new table means just right click new table. How to create a new table I will teach. Right click new table. Here enter your column name, like ID. So here we set your data type. My data type is varchar, and names here I will set varchar, and salary I will set here float. So point value also it will come. For that only we mention the float here. And age, here I will declare as a int. So just I will control S, save, or else I will click save icon here. It will save the my table. So right now you will ask the table name, what table name here. So I will just give salary and click OK. So it will save our DB. Okay, in the DB you will get to know the salary. In that salary so many columns will be there. One is ID, names, and salary and ages, like that so many columns is there. Like that only we created the this structure. So column section, book ID, book name, and everything. See here,
here I will show bookmaster. See, bookmaster having book ID, book name, author, edition, pages, published, and SR ID and status. Like that only we created the structures. Okay, we need then we have to refer this flow data structure. We have to create like that your DB. So this DB, for example, only I created. Sorry, this table I example only I created, so that I will remove that table. Okay, just click delete. It will remove the tables. So you want to show your complete table structure, means you need to click your data diagram and click yes. It will ask right click and new database diagram. Inside database diagram you have to add all columns here. See, your database diagram also it created successfully. Okay, like that you have to see the all the database diagrams, a table view and columns standard. So you want to see the table structure also, we can create the table structures here. See, I will select all the tables, here and right click view equal to standard. So you will get the all the table structures here. So what the structure I am created here. So this is for stock, this is for section, this is for role master, this is for rack master, this is for member master, this is member transactions, and books register sub and book register main and book master. Here everything I will use int, and book purchase sub and purchase main and profile master and plan master. So now I will show the columns and as well as data types also. So you have to see that data types. Based on data type you have to create your structure as per the your requirement also. Now I will show the all the details. Okay, we will do next steps means we will create the based on this layout we will create the design into Visual Studio. That and all we will see later. Visual Studio. See, we already created the designs in library management system here. So just I open my project. So based on flow diagram I created these designs. So here book register, book master and book out register, change password, so many things I created. That means all the forms I created only design section without coding. Okay, see here login. So first we will discuss about login here. So this is the login form. So this is text box 1, this is text box 2, and username and password and exit button and login button and forget password. So like that we created the structure here based on the our flow charts. Okay, we will create how to make a project, how to write the code. So many people will start our first project or beginning project here. So for that I will teach how to create a forms and how to make a create a projects, new projects, and basic things first. After completing the basic things, I will teach how to write the code and all. So you need to create new project. How to create a new project, first I will tell. Click Visual Studio. Here I will using Visual Studio 2003. So in file new project. So here I am using Windows applications. So for that we have to choose Visual C Sharp and Windows Desktop. In the desktop you have to click Windows Form Applications. Here you will give your project name, and here you will give the your directory, which directory you gonna to create your project. That directory you have to choose here and click OK. That means your project will be created. That is the basic things. So once successfully created your project, means that form new window, new form only it will come, just like add Windows form and click. So form one only it will come here. So this is our first form, it will come. So here you have to right click and rename it your whichever name you want. You have to rename it here, or else better thing, you have to create new form, right click add, right click your solution name or project name and click add. In that add you have to click new item. New item you will find the Windows form. Here you have to provide your form name, whatever form name you want, just you have to provide it here. Yes, yes, like I will put, for example I will put salary, salary.cs and click OK. Add. So salary form will created here. So we need to set this form is a starting form, then just drag down here and you have to find program.cs. In that program.cs you have to double click that program.cx. A already predefined, pre-created function will be there. This is the static void main. In that application.run function you have to return your form name. My form name is right now is salary, so I will put here salary, salary, just put the salary and hit the run button, or else go to debug and click start debug here, or else press F5, it will run the debug mode. So and click this start debug. So first form it will run as a salary. See, is successfully created one new project. In that project we gonna add so many controls, so many forms. For time being we already explained about the structures and designs and all. So I will delete this form. For time being I already created the that forms here, and I already created the designs and all. So I will teach how to do the designs and every step by step. Okay, first we will discuss about login form. So go to login form. This is two label, this is two text boxes, this is buttons, this is link, hyperlink labels. So how to create that first form I will teach. So here toolbox section you will get to know so many tools here, or else view you have to click the toolbox. Okay, it will comes the toolbox. Once it came the toolbox, you have to click here, it will standardly fixed here. You have to click this, it will hide. Okay, so now I standardly fix here. Click that expand this command controls. So command controls only we will use most commonly. So for that we will use command control. In that command control here I will change the my form size, whatever we need. I can change here form size. I will change the form size, as well as I need to add labels here. Labels, see labels I added here, and right click the labels and go to the properties, or else click your label and press F4 key in your keyboard. You will get the properties window. In that properties window I need to change my font and size of this label. So for that just you have to drag up here. You will find the font options. In that font options so many will be there, but you have to click this dotted button here, such link button here. So the link button navigate into font window. In that font window, you have to choose whatever font you need and whatever font shell you need and whatever size you need. You can set your font and you can set your sizes. So here I am using GUI font I am using, and regular and font size I am using 10. For that, all the fonts I am using the same font and same font style and same font size in all our projects. So here we created the label. Likewise, we have to add any button. You need to add any button. Just track your button here. Okay, track your button here. You can change the font size as likewise. You have to change here. Way and regular font size 10 and click OK. So it will successfully create your font. So you need to change your button text. Right click and go to properties. In that text section, you need to you want to change, means you can change here. Just close, it will change. So you need to add like underline for any text. Just go to text and put double time and click, sorry, single time and symbol. It will comes in a underscore. See, before which letter you want to show the underline, before that letter you need to add that and symbol. It will comes in a underline. Okay, and this is a link label is here. Just click here. You have to change your font size as well as whatever text you need to add here. So this is the basic functionality to create the forms. So here I created login forms. So once I exit, means I need to exit the program. So for that, I need to double click this button. The which button? So right click and click view designer. Again, you have to navigate to design page, and right click view code. You can navigate to code page, or else you have to click here, press F7 in keyboard. You will navigate to code window, and shift F7 you navigate to designer window. So like that you have to navigate whatever you want. You have to navigate here. Okay, say okay. One more thing, now I created two buttons. I hit this exit button, it will create the events for this. So by default, text box always it will be click event, and label will always be change event. See, I double click this exit button, it will button 2 hyphen and click. That means click event is created here. See, and I double click this login button, again it will click event is created. And one more thing, you have to double click this username button, so it will create in a text change event. So that means based on the control, by default window it will create. So you want to, so many events will be there. Every control having so many events. You want to see what and all events is applicable for this text boxes, for this buttons. So how to see that? So just click any control and press F4 in your keyboard. So you will get properties tab. In that properties tab, one icon will be there, that is event icon. So click that event icon. See how many event is applicable for this text boxes. So tab, accept tab changed, and click event, change event, drag event, drag over, mouse click, see mouse click, mouse double click, mouse down, mouse enter, mouse over. So many events will be there. Whatever events you want, just click here and press enter key in your keyboard, it will automatically create the event for that. So like that, you have to create whatever event you want. So in your button you want to resize event, then just click enter, it will create the resize event. And control Z means it will undo your events. Okay, right now we are using only button 2 click event and button 1 click event. Okay, see, we created successfully in two events how to create the, we discussed about two events, about events, about designs, and everything we discussed in that this form, that means that login form we discussed very well. Okay, now once I exit, I need to close the form, close the entire project. For that I will use this dot so this dot close side this dot close see this dot close just I am using this dot close and click start. See, throwing the error. Why? We are by default we are creating the salary form is a default form, but we deleted that salary form. So right now we need to by default login form only we need to run by default. So for that, in program section we have to enter that your program. So in case any error is there, it will show the blue mark. Okay, so here I will change login. So by default program is starting program is login, starting form is login. Okay, and hit our project. So it compiled successfully and run our program successfully. This is the login form, and I click exit. Exit means it will close entire project. See, entire project was closed. So I need to create now login form. So login successfully login. So how to navigate the home screen, that and all I will teach here. Okay, see here, before to create write the code for login, we need to create the home screen. Home screen is LMS, that is master page, sorry, MDI parent page. Once this is MDI parent, it linked with other forms into this MDI parent. That means that time that form, that these forms and all considered as a child forms. This is considered as a parent form. So while creating the MDI parent, by default this option will be coming. So we no need these options, for we are customizing the our forms. For that, first you have to select here. We no need this option. So just click here, delete button in your keyboard, it will delete. So no need this menu, just click delete, delete and delete and delete and delete and delete. So all the options were deleted successfully. Okay, now right click and view code. So many predefined code also here it created. So these codes and all no need for our project. We will return our own codes. Okay, for that just I will delete all the functions here and hit the save buttons. So you should hit the save button, that then only it won't throw the error, or else it will throw the errors. Okay, now go to the designs. Now we will create the menus for our reference. So we already created the flow layout. For that, here I will create masters. Here I will create inventory. Here I will create reports. So I created successfully inventory. Here I will create like a role master, and profile. So like that we can create so many menus here. Okay, we will discuss this later. Now we going to this login form. So click your login form, your design section, you'll click this login. Once I hit the login, I need to redirect my form, login form to LMS form, LMS main parent form. So for that we need to call that LMS here. So LMS, that form name we need to type here and create the object for that. OPGD object equal to new LMS I created. So OPJ dot show. So that means it automatically create your call your project here. So once I hit the that login button, just I click the start button here. We will check. Right now we didn't return any write any code for that validations, username and password. Just we are created here and click this login. Our LMS form, it's opened here by default. See, click this maximize, it will maximize your forms here. So by default I need to maximize this screen. So how to set and all I will teach. So still this program is running. Once you click the login button, the program that login, that LMS form is showing here, but program is still running. So how to do that, how to manage that and all also I will teach. Okay, first I need to by default I need to increase my screen size. So let's click LMS in LMS form in Solution Explorer and go to the properties, right click and properties. In that, sorry, first open your project and go to your properties here. Sorry, click the form and go to properties. Open your LMS form and click LMS form and go to your properties. So you'll get so many options here. In that option, Windows state one will be there. In that Windows state, you will set maximized and hit the save button and click once again. So click, by default that program is showing is big screen, so full screen, that means maximized screen is showing here. Okay guys, we will see. Once I close this program main form, still our project will is running. See here, so for the what the reason that login form is still is running. So once I hit the login, successful login, click the login, I need to close this login form and I need to only show our LMS main form only. Once I close that main form, I need to close entire project. So that is our big deal. So many people are struggling in that. So I will give that code here, how to make this and all. Okay, see, go to login, here click login. Once successfully login, I need to hide. So this dot hide, first step I am do to hide, this means this login form. So I am click login form. See login form, I clicked here and click login button. See LMS form is came, that login form is won't show, that means that login form is hidden mode. Okay, now click this exit. Sorry, one more thing I forgot to tell. I click login, that form is came here, and click close LMS, but still program is running. Why? That means that login form is still not close, it in hidden mode only. Hidden means hide mode only. For that, hide mode only. For that, we need to how to handle this kind of situation. But we never do here close. This dot close option, one more option also is there. This dot close means this form will be close. But see, close. form will be close here. See, the problem is you use that form close, entire project also it will close. So it will show the login like main form. After we will use this dot close, that means that form entire project will close. Why? Because by default program we set login only. So once login form is closed, entire project will be closed. So for that we will use only hidden only, hide only. But we can override our close functions. So once I close the LMS means, then only I need to close entire project. So how to handle this kind of situation? Just right click your project and go to event section. In that event section you have to navigate form closed. This event I will fire. In that event I will use this dot
so here
this dot exit. Application dot exit. We will use one more function, application dot exit. So once form closed, that time this event will fire. So before what we are doing, once form closed, this form only, LMS form only is closed, but that login form still is running in background. Okay, for that application dot exit means background whatever form execute also it automatically it will close. Okay, so I will hit the program, run the program and click login button. It program is showing here and click this exit. So our application successfully closed. Okay, now we will going to return
now
the login
to
create the menus into LMS. So here I have created some menus only. Now I need to create all the menus here by order. Okay, we already created LMS profile and we need to map in this menu to member master and plan and rack and so many things we need to map here. So for that I will add member and plan and rack and section and section rack map. So we created those many items here. In inventory section we need to add purchase. Book in register and out register. Book in register. Book out register. And member transaction. Member transaction. Member transaction. Transaction. What an profile master we created, book register we created, book master we created. This change password we need to set in here only.
change password LMS, okay, login, okay, member master we created, member transaction we created, plan created, profile master we created, purchase created, rack created, role created, section, okay, everything we created. In report section we need to add some forms, that and all we will add later. Okay, now we need to once I click role, then we need to show the role page, so role form. For that we will return the code, double click this role. Here it will create role tool strip menu item dot click event. Here I will call role object. So we have to create same name here, then it will very useful. OBJ, okay, OBJ, OBJ equal to new object. Here obj dot show. Now I save the program and run and click login, and LMS page is came. Here go to master, I click role, so role page is came. But we have to see one more thing here. See, role page is came, but it you have to track now. It goes under, sorry, above the LMS, but we need to set here only. See here, two page created, LMS separately and two page open and role separately. That means this is not a correct way, but we need to show this role page inside in LMS. So how to set that? So for that we need to set LMS role. You have to go to properties here, click that form, so we can set program by program also. We know here MDI parent will be there. I have to set MDI container, means it will act as a MDI form, but no need that MDI container. So we have to do one thing, go to here, we will set OBJ object dot MDI parent, you will get parent equal to this. This means it will get the, this means LMS form, this automatically get here, and put save. And now run once again, click login. So now click role. See, it's not creating the one more object, one more window here. It automatically comes inside. See, inside only it will work now. So the form, the role form is inside. So one more thing I will teach. Here I click role, it comes here. Again click role, it comes somewhere else. Okay, for that we need to set by default, I need to it come in center position. So for that what we do, just go object dot Windows state, I think form state dot, so not position, just a minute. Here starting position, you have to just starting position and center. Starting position center, we will set the starting position center and run the program and click login. Now go to master and click role, it always comes in center. So like that you have to do that. Okay, now we need to add like that all the controls here. So for that just I click all the controls once again and copy
and paste it here. Profile. Profile master. Just change the profile master and save. And member. Track. Section. Section map. And change profile. So here I will set one by one. Change password, just copy and paste it, and section rack, rack map, control C and control V, section, and rack. And plan. And the member. Member master. Profile, profile master, role, role master. So everything now I done successfully, and click hit the run button and click login. Here I will click role, it will comes role, and profile, profile is game, and member, member master is game, and plan, plan master is game, and rack, section, section track map, and change password. So everything is came. For that we need to do this purchase and purchase receipt, register everything. So just go to designer and click here, purchase, book register, book out register, and member register. Just copy this. Member transaction. So member transaction, copy and paste it. This is book out register, out register, copy and paste it. This is book in register, in register, copy and paste it. This is purchase. So everything I done, just I click hit the run button, click login, and inventory also it's game. Okay, everything is work perfectly now. Okay, now we have to return the code for login form. So click login. Here once I exit, it will close the applications, and login, it will login the applications. Say okay. But login means I need to set username and password. That username password is correct, then only it should be login, right? So for that I will return here. If text box 1 dot text equal to admin, and text box 2 dot text equal to password, then should log in this. Else, show message. Message box dot show invalid username or password. So I hit the program. Sorry, here we need to missed it, this colon. Now I hit the run button. Here I will give admin and password. I will give anything. I hit the button, it will show invalid username or password. Okay, see here message box. You will see this message box is very blank. It's not like good. So we need to format this message box also. So for that we will add. So text alert and message box icons dot error and hit the here message box buttons dot okay. So okay button and error icon will be error and text will be alert. So now I hit the program and click here. See error icon. This is error means error icon it came, and OK button means by default is OK button. Here also I'm passing default button only. OK, it will OK, and this alert is showing as a header. So I formatted this message box also. OK, now I giving admin password and click login. It will login successfully. OK, one more thing. So password should be not visible, is showing directly. Na? So for that, go to properties and password character. You will find the password character. I will put here any symbol, star or dot or anything you can give. Here I will put dollar sign. Okay. Now save the program and run the project. Here I will give admin. Here P A S S W O R E. I written correct only, but it will visible only is star like a dollar symbol. So I click login, it will perfectly login. Okay, one. Now I need to link with database. So it should check with database. It database that record is exists. Database that username and password is exists, then only we need we possible to login and all. By default I will create one username and password for that DB. Okay, so here server explorer is there. In that server explorer I will connect that SQL DB here itself. No need to open Visual Studio sorry SQL server every time. You have to give your server name. Server name you have to give your dot. Dot means it will automatically take your computer name. In case you are using SQL Express edition, that time you have to give dot slash and give SQL Express. Like that you have to give, it will connect your SQL Express database. Okay, or else you have to give your whatever server name you have to give. Okay, now I will using Windows authentication. So you have specify any username and password, then you have to provide the username and password here. But I will use Windows authentication. Here I will select my DBs. So here it will showing the LMS DB it's showing, and select the DB and click OK. So my DB was connected here. Okay, and click here. We will get the tables, view, store, procedure, functions, scenarios, types, and we will go to tables. In the table we created for this login purpose, we will use which table? Profile master only. So in profile master I will go. So here user ID and password will be there. By default here no record is there. So right click and show data, you will get the you will show all the records here. By default here no record is there. So I will create one user ID, admin, and name equal to administrator, and email I will give aa@gmail.com, and mobile number that and all I will update later. I will give the password equal to pass, just I will give the password. Address role I will put admin, and status I will put active. So I updated successfully. Okay, now we need to log in. That time we need to call the DB. Okay, so for that we need to connect SQL connections here. For that I will declare the SQL connections here. So using system.data.sql client, so this is the namespace for connecting the SQL server. Okay, here I will declare one connection string. So SQL connection CON equal to new SQL connections. Here I will put the connection string. So you no need how to get the connection string, just you click your DB and go to properties. You will get the connection string here. Just click this connection string and put Control A and Control C. Copy. Just copy. And paste it here. That's it. So your connection string ready. This is data source will be dot. And the initial catalog is your database name. And this is server name. This is database name. Integrator security means security true means it will by default it will take your system username and password. That's it. Okay, you get right. You got right. So here what I have to do, I need to connect. So here I will use SQL data adapter SDA equal to new SQL data adapter. So here I will return the code. So select star, or else you need only username and password, right? User ID and password. So for that I will use pro_user_id. So where it is your, this is your column name, that column name only I get it here. So just I will replace it. And we need password, so pro, just copy this password and paste it here. And from which DB? Profile master. Okay, but okay, one more thing I will tell here. So we need to validate from DB only. So for that just copy this, where user ID equal to, I need to set the text box single quote double quote plus text box one dot text plus double quote single quote comma other one is, sorry, not comma, and profile password. Here profile password equal to single quote double quote plus text box two dot text plus double quote single quote, and comma, in outside the comma CON. I need to specify the connections here. So now here no need anything here. Just put one or else put star, anything you can put here. So okay, here select star from profile master where profile ID equal to text box 1 and password is equal to text box 2. That values, both values is true, then only the values will comes here. So for that we need to call this. So for that we need to declare one data table. Data table. So you are using data table means you should mention the system dot data, then only you have possible to create the data table object here. So here DT equal to new data table, here SDA dot fill DT. Fill DT. Now I will check here DT dot rows dot count equal to 1. That means in case user ID and password is matches, then the data table getting some data, some rows. So that rows equal to 1, count will be, row count will be equal to 1, then only it will comes here, or else it will go to invalid username and password, it will showing like that. Okay, so you are using, one more thing I need to mention here, SQL data adapter. You are using SQL data adapter, then you are no need to mention connection open and connection close, because SQL data adapter it automatically handle the connection state. So it will open and close, it will automatically open, and once the connection is executed, that query is executed, after it automatically close that connections. Okay, so for first time I will put debug mode here, and how the record will be going and how it's running at all I will teach. Okay, just hit the program here. I will put admin and password PASS. I will put here and click login. So it comes debug mode here, and press F10 in your keyboard, then it will go step by step. Okay, so here text box 1 having admin text, you have to just move your mouse move upper the text box, you will get the text, what the text is having the text box. So it here admin is there, in text box 2 having PAS password, that password will be there. So the query, how the query is going here, you can go here, select, you have to say SDA and click this icon, and select command, you have to click select command, and command text, you will find the command text here. So like that only the command will be passed into SQL query, sorry, SQL server. So that means select start from profile master where profile user ID equal to admin and password equal to PAS. Like that it will pass. Okay, and F10 and fill all the values, what the values, what the result will come now, that result I will fill into DT data table. Now go to data table, click this search icon is there now, here to click the search icon, you will get the values. So every value is coming here. See here the row, so how many row is here? Only one, that is the row count we are using. Row count means here it will come 1, here equal to 1. So both condition is matches, then it will automatically goes into if conditions, inner if condition, and show the record and hide the values. See, successfully run. So this is the login forms. Okay, once I, in case I will put anything wrong, that time we will check admin. So here PASS and click here, it will goes inner. Now check the DT rows count, see here no row is there, that means row count will be 0 and here equal to 1, so condition is false. There it automatically redirect into message section invalid username or password. Okay, like that it will show. So we done successfully login forms here. And I will change here admin and click login once again and press F10. So successfully we log in here and click close F10. So successfully close. Okay guys, other than we will teach in next video section.